must be stopped. We must make contact.
Reports of flying saucers are nothing new.
These are routine sightings, not isolated events.
Are you seeing that? It's spinning. There's a whole swarm of them.
Oh, my God. They're all against the wind. All against the wind.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, look at this. That's 110, 100 feet.
There was an historic hearing today on Capitol Hill and an unprecedented bipartisan push for UFO transparency.
I told you to take Broadway. This always happens.
Why are you here? State your purpose.
To find a place to...
Yeah, it's some weird shit.
It's weird. It's very weird. It's all very creepy. And the fact that it was a real place. I told you, like, I was telling people that Alex Jones told me about that.
Before he talked like that. His voice wasn't as scraggly. All the years of tequila and vodka. But,
I thought it was nuts, and it turned out to be true.
Yeah, but...
Yeah, it's a fucked up world we live in. We need Jesus. I think for real. Like, if he came back now, it'd be great. Like, Jesus, if you're thinking about coming back...
Right now?
Now's a good time.
Yeah, pretty soon, yeah.
Now's a good time. We're kind of fucked.
Well, there's a lot of people that think that might be coming.
Well, it might be.
Mark of the Beast.
That might be the aliens. I mean, that might be what all this stuff is. It might be we reach a certain point where we're so unmanageable and so chaotic that something comes down and gives us a guideline. I mean, this is what Moses essentially experienced, supposedly, right? When he came back with his Ten Commandments. This is supposedly what, you know, these people that have had these religious visions. There's a way to follow, and there's a greater power that's above everything that controls this whole thing and keeps it all together.
This shit matters.
Yeah.
That, you know,
it does matter.
Yeah, like everything we do matters. I think if, you know, atheists, I think, can answer a religion of climate change or whatever it might be, but to not believe in a higher power means that really nothing I do matters, ultimately. I live, I die, that's it. I have a hard time with that because I believe there's a seen world and an unseen world, and there's forces of good and forces of evil, and that there's a purpose for all this, and there's... you know, there's a lot of reasons why we're doing this. There's a lot of opportunities to do this. If there is the Christianity part and Jesus wants to come back.
Shalom, call halal, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak, Wadash, that's giving all praise to the Most High. In the name of His only begotten Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone who taught us His truth and sincerity. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. And real quick in this video, I want to touch on the fact of the UFOs. Okay, the first video you saw was from the elder Manasseh Zagba. And he went, you know, he always goes into it, you know, the Super Bowl halftime or whatever. And they had a bunch of, you know, commercials and videos about these UFOs. Okay, then the next video was Joe Rogan, you know, saying how he believes that those UFOs are the chariots of the scriptures, and he even said chariots, okay, and then he mentioned this scripture in Ezekiel, okay, which describes the wheel in the midst of a wheel, and that's what you saw in that first video with that UFO that was flying over the people. It was like a wheel within a wheel, and everybody was looking down at their phones, all right, which is spiritual too, because last week at our camp, you know, one of these known scoffers that's been scoffing for years, this guy passed by the camp, and because we had moved, you know, so he found us again. And he just happened to walk past, and he said, "Oh, what's up, flying saucer guys?" You know, so these people, you know, they it's a lot of talk about the chariots right now, and the reason why is because the Lord is about to, you know, show you people that he's going to come in a great ship, you know. And I believe first before that even happens, there's going to be, you know, a false flag with this Project Blue Beam stuff. But then the Lord is going to come in the real ships and show the world, you know, those UFOs are the angels. It ain't no little green men. You know, they showed you the aliens, which that's what demons look like. You know, so Esau's trying to deceive you, make you think that there's some green aliens in there or gray aliens, when really it's the holy angels. Okay, so real quick, let's grab a few scriptures going into these chariots. This is Ezekiel chapter 10, verse 9. It says, "And when I looked, behold, the four wheels by the cherubim, one wheel by one cherub and another wheel by another cherub. And the appearance of the wheels was like as the color of a beryl stone," right? Which is describing what you call UFOs. It says, "As for their appearances, they four had one likeness, as if a wheel had been in the midst of a wheel," okay? And that's what you saw in that first video, you know, with the chariots, okay? It looks like a wheel in the midst of another wheel, all right? And that just shows you that, hey, the Lord is definitely moving throughout the earth, man. Okay, let me grab this too. Because when the Lord comes back, he's going to come back in a gigantic chariot, okay? Let me grab this real quick. Speaking on that, let me see, Salakia. Let's go here, because we are in this time where the Lord is going to start, you know, revealing himself more, you know, and also through these ships, okay. The week before last, we had a huge chariot fly over our camp, you know, as we was dealing with, you know, some brothers, some individuals. A chariot flew over the camp, you know, and then the chariot changed shape in the midst of us teaching this man, okay, which is you know, a powerful thing, you know, and it was a faith booster, you know, to even see it, you know, as we was looking at it, and I did a video on the last week, but as we looking at this chariot, it changed shape, man, all right, and the chariots are going to start getting closer and closer, you know, especially in these last days. And we're going to start seeing more miracles, you know, and signs in the heavens. This is Psalms chapter 68, verse 17. "The chariots of the Most High are 20,000, even thousands of angels. And the Lord is among them as in Sinai in the holy place." So the Lord is among these ships. Okay, he's going to be in the midst of these ships, man. All right, he's coming with a great cloud. All right, let me grab this too. Because in these last days, we're starting to see, you know, and everybody's talking about it, which I still got to do that video about it, about Project Bluebeam. They're saying how this year, you know, that they're supposed to be, you know, coming up with this Project Bluebeam thing to bring in a new world order and deceive the masses, which could very well, you know, could very well happen. But those of us that know, we're not going to be taken, you know, we're not going to be deceived by this, because we know, you know, what must come to pass before the Lord comes back, which is that kerygma. All right, if there was an alien invasion right now before the chariots even came, then we would know that this is some, you know, shit that Esau, you know, plant, because, you know, the prophecies must take place first, and that RFID micro C-hip must be implanted in majority of the people on the face of the earth before the Lord does make his second return. It says Isaiah chapter 66 verse 15, "For behold, the Lord Yahweh will come with his fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire." So the Lord is coming, all right, in those ships, and that ship is going to be like a whirlwind, okay? It's going to, you know, shake everything up, man. The whole world is going to stop, like the movie Day the Earth Stood Still, or like the movie Independence Day. You sure that movie Independence Day, everybody stopped, you know, people was crashing their cars, people were stopping in traffic to look up. It showed you that in that first scene too, from the NFL commercial, how people was all looking at their phone, and then the aliens projected something to their phone, and everybody stopped and looked up. So that's the time that we are coming into. The Lord is going to, you know, do something in this earth. It says, Jeremiah chapter 4, verse 13, "Behold, he shall come as clouds," okay, and this clouds is spiritual for the chariots, "and his chariots shall be like a whirlwind, his horses are swifter than eagles. Woe unto us, for we are spoiled," right? So his chariots shall come, you know, swifter than eagles. And if you see eagles, what do eagles do? Do eagles run, you know, like an actual chariot and carriage? No, eagles fly. So these chariots are flying. All right, I'll grab one more real quick. Let me go back to here real quick, though, first before I even go any further. Isaiah 66, verse 15 again. For behold, Yahweh will come with fire, and his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury, and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will Yahweh plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Yahweh shall be many. So the Lord is going to plead with you people, you know, by fire and by his sword. Okay, he's going to plead with all flesh. Like, people are going to die. All right, another good movie to watch is the movie War of the Worlds. Now, those ships was like three-legged, you know, vessels that came out of the ground. But, you know, which, you know, the scriptures, you know, describe that too. These chariots, you know, they have these, you know, three legs that can, you know, come out of the ships, and so it can stand, you know, upon earth, you know, or it can hover. You know, but that's symbolic too, because when those ships came out of the ground, what's the first thing they started doing? They started zapping people. Okay, they started zapping people, and that's Bible prophecy. That's why it says, for by fire and by his sword will Yahweh plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. So there's so many people are going to be slain by the Most High. All right, and this is why we got to come back to the Most High in truth and sincerity, hoping to be saved, because ultimately when the Lord does come, there's going to be a nuclear annihilation, you know, prior, you know, or the Lord's going to come prior to a nuclear annihilation. And you, in order to be saved, you have to be saved from that fire, which is what the scriptures talk about, the lake of fire. America's going to be engulfed in flames, and us being on this land, we need to be delivered from that fire. It says Isaiah 31 verse 5, as birds flying, so will Yahweh of hosts, which means the Yahweh of armies, defend Jerusalem. But Jerusalem is a people before it's a place. It's not talking about the land. It's a people before it's a place. All right, the Lord says he's going to defend Jerusalem, which is, you know, Israel, the elect of Israel predominantly. So the elect that's here in America, you know, Lord, when we be a part of that number, the Lord is going to defend them, okay, from that fire that's coming. It says as birds flying. And how do birds fly? They fly in uniform. Okay, and what they migrate. So the chariots are going to migrate from one side of the earth, the east, over here to the west. After, you know, the Lord destroys those armies in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, he's going to, you know, migrate across the oceans with those ships. They showed you that in Independence Day. And then he's going to deliver, you know, the children of Israel. It says, defending also he will deliver it, and passing over he will preserve it. You see? So, in that, we want the Lord to have mercy upon us and preserve us, you know, and deliver us. It says, turn ye unto him from whom the children of Israel have deeply revolted. He didn't say Christians. He didn't say Muslims. He said, whom the children of Israel have deeply revolted. Because when the Lord comes back, he's only coming back to deliver the children of Israel. If you don't know that you're an Israelite, you don't know who Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is, there's a great chance that you're not going to be saved. Okay, you must know who he is and his glory, and you know, give praise unto him. It says, for in that day every man shall cast away his idols of silver and his idols of gold, which your hands have made unto you for a sin. Yeah, so your money ain't gonna be able to save you in that day, man. Okay, your money ain't gonna be able to save you. But I just thought this was spiritual, how this individual, I just happened to come across that video the other day. This guy Joe Rogan, which he, you know, he says a lot of outlandish, you know, crazy stuff, but what he said there was, you know, it was all fact, and it's spiritual, because he grabbed, you know, he quoted the scripture. All right, that's what made me want to go into this, you know, but showed you that these people, they know. Let me grab this too. All right, the truth is out there. Let me grab an NLT. I got it right here. It says, this is the book of Zechariah, chapter 5, verse 1. It says in the KJV, it says, then I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, a flying roll. Okay, so he said a flying roll. All right, he says, and he said unto me, the angel, what seest thou? Which is a rhetorical question. He says, and I answered, I see a flying roll. So he saw a flying roll. Okay, and on the NLT, it says a flying scroll. All right, which is a chariot, man. All right, let's read it in the NLT. It says, Zechariah 1, chapter 5, verse 1. I looked up again and saw a scroll flying through the air. So what is a scroll doing flying through air? That's talking about these vehicles, these ships. All right. It says, what do you see? The angel asks, I see a flying roll, a flying scroll. I replied, it appears to be about 30 feet long and 15 feet wide. It says, and then he said unto me, this scroll contains the curse that is going out over the entire land. Okay, over the whole earth. One side of the scroll says that those who steal will be banished from the land. And the other side says that those who swear falsely will be banished from the land. So, and you know, in KJV it says, then he said he unto me, this is a curse that goeth forth over the whole earth, over the face of the whole earth, because you got these chariots being seen all over the earth. Okay, and people want, when these elites try to do something and the Lord didn't sanction it, it's the chariots that come and stop it. You know, there's videos of chariots messing with the fighter jets. You know, there's videos of chariots stopping rockets and missiles from launching. There's videos of chariots coming out of volcanoes right before they erupt. There's videos of chariots. I saw a video one time of like two or three chariots, and it was inside of these tornadoes, and it was, you know, pretty much stirring up those tornadoes. So this is the curse that goeth before the whole earth. You know, no matter what Esau tries to do, he can only do what the Lord allows. And how do we know that? Because these ships are there to stop them from, you know, doing anything that the Lord has not sanctioned. Okay. It says, for everyone that stealeth, it's luck here, shall be cut off on this side according to it, and everyone that sweareth shall be cut off on that side according to it. Which means, you know, well, Esau stole us, you know, brought us into this land in captivity. It says, I will bring it forth, saith Yahweh of hosts, and it shall enter into the house of the thief, which is America, and into the house of him that sweareth falsely by my name. And it shall remain in the midst of his house, and shall consume it with the timber thereof and the stones thereof. And I saw a post the other day of a picture, and it said it showed the world map. It said how the world looks, and then it had another map, and it said how the world looks to aliens in the UFOs, and it just had America. Why? Because predominantly of these sightings of these ships are over here in America. People see majority of these UFO sightings over here in America. Why? Because this is the land that's going to be a great sacrifice. This is also the land that the Lord is going to come to deliver his elect. Okay, America is going to be a lake of fire. So the Lord is moving heavy in this land. All right, that's all spiritual. And if you have the spiritual eyes to see, you'll be able to get it. If not, you won't be able to get it. But that's fine too. You know, because everybody's going to come to understand, you know, these things that we understand, whether it be through the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, or through death by pain. All right, so it says, so that's the point. All right, so it says, it shall remain in the house of the thief. It shall enter into the house of the thief, and it shall remain in the midst of his house. So these chariots are constantly being seen over here in America. All right, and that's not by coincidence. Like I said, that's not by coincidence. That's by design. All right, the Lord is, you know, going to do something miraculous in this earth. Let me grab this too. Because when this destruction comes, you want to be delivered. All right, you want to be delivered. It says Isaiah chapter 26 verse 20. Come, my people. Notice he didn't say all people. He said my people. Enter thou into thy chambers and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself as if it were for a little moment, until the indignation be overpassed, right? The righteous anger. Because the Lord is pissed off. You know, the Lord is pissed off, and you don't want to get, you know, caught up in the Lord's judgment. So that righteous anger is going to be when he send that fire, you know. You know, you're going to taste the whole wrath of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, and he bring that judgment upon this place. Okay? So he says, enter into thy chambers, which the elect are going to enter into those chambers, which are those ships, you know, to be delivered from the destruction that's coming. It says, for behold, Yahweh cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. The earth also shall disclose her blood, and there shall, it's like, and shall no more cover her slain. Okay, so that's the point. All right, great death and destruction is coming. And if you don't repent, then you will be destroyed, which ultimately the elect who are predestined to be saved will be delivered. Those are the ones that's going to repent and that's going to come back to Yahweh Bashem Yahshai and start serving him in truth and sincerity. All right. And you better pray that be you. But I just want to touch on that real quick. I don't make this too long. You know, you got this guy Joe Rogan speaking about it. You got all over the Super Bowl. You had chariots. You had this guy come past the camp last week talking about, oh, he called us flying saucer boys, which, hey, you gonna wish you was a flying saucer boy when that fire come, man. When nuclear missiles are in the sky, everybody gonna wish that there was a flying saucer boy then, because they're gonna see the elect being delivered. Scriptures talk about the strangeness of his salvation. You see, so right now it's a joke. You know, they make no account of our labors. They scoff, they mock. You know, they had us in derision, you know, calling us this, that, and the third and crazy. But pretty soon you're gonna wish that you was, you know, a flying saucer boy. All right, and a spiritual, because the video first started off talking about flying saucers. They had flying saucers on the TV. All right, so yeah, we in that time, man. All right, it's not by coincidence. Yahweh Bashem Yahshua is doing his thing in the earth, and you know, we are grateful that we have this knowledge, wisdom, understanding, and get a chance to be a part of this. Okay, get a chance to be a part of this. Lord, when the Lord keep us. All right, no, none of us know if we're saved yet. That's why you gotta always remain humble. Because we hope the Lord keep us, man. It's one thing to come into this truth. It's another thing to endure to the end. All right, it's locked in. But yeah, so I pray it's been edifying to the hopeful elect. With that being said, I'm going to say Shalom, Kwame Sharala, Abba Abba, Double Honor, Sorry, Elder, and Apostle, and Millstone, who calls this truth and truth and sincerity. Shalom.